Greetings, everybody. It is Shadow Kruger here, and I have talked about this series once before. Now I'm here with my two friends, Kelly and Ryan. I'm sure you guys remember Ryan from my birthday, and Kelly is someone from our economics and government class. She was randomly sitting behind us one day, and then she got the idea to sit at our table, and thus here we are now. So I talked about this in a vlog where I was going to have these guys come and do a series with me, and now we're going to do Sonic Heroes. So here we are today, and this is the opening cinematic showing all four of the teams. So, and you both have gotten a little bit of a taste with the game and its mechanics, and Ryan, you had a hard time, and Kelly got it pretty much the first time she did it. So, yeah, Ryan struggled very, very hard. It was ridiculous. But yeah.
Oh, did you know that Eggman was actually based off of the caricature of an egg in Theodore Roosevelt?
He was?
He was.
He was based off of Theodore Roosevelt
and
what?
He was based off of Theodore Roosevelt as a caricature
in an egg. That's ridiculous. Oh yeah, and then there's Metal Sonic. I'm the final boss. Looks pretty menacing, right? But yeah, so we're gonna basically do this this Let's Play the same way that the Super Gaming Brothers did their Sonic Heroes playthrough, where we each take formations of a separate team, and then we're going to share controllers for Team Chaotix. The Chaotix is indeed going to be chaotic.
I worry.
Alright, so let's go and get this PS2 version loading. So it's gonna load up the main screen, and then we'll get started.
You should have, like elevator music.
Elevator music.
Yeah. Please hold.
Please hold right now.
Place
if you want
sound.
A real human being, please hold for 4 hours.
Oh my god.
I'm a real human being.
Hello? Welcome!
Welcome to Tokyo, Japan!
The funny
what
is,
do you want?
In Japan, with an East Indian accent?
There it goes,
you're
finally.
Anything in Japan.
There it goes, finally.
Literally, they'll turn you into a robot.
They'll turn you into a robot, okay.
They'll make you into a robot and then fight Godzilla with yeah.
Alright, here we go. And I'm gonna start this LP off because I wanna have these guys watch the gameplay a little bit, because even though they basically got a way of how the game goes so far, it's just best to watch a little bit of it as well, so you can get a little bit of an idea. So there we go, finally.
Music.
Yeah. Alright, so the four teams, Team Sonic, Team Dark, Team Rose, and Team Chaotix. Oh my god, that was great. Alright.
You never know when I'm around.
Just like twirls. Oh my god. This, as you guys can tell already, this is going to be a really, really crazy and stupid LP. So,
pretty stupid.
Pretty stupid.
When are they not, though?
Yeah, exactly. When are they not? Even on my solo LPs, they can be pretty ridiculous. So, alright, let's go ahead and get started. Now, the only team with some sort of actual backstory is Team Dark. The rest of them are here just for general reasons. And we'll learn about the actual stories behind these the other three when we get to it. Well, let's go ahead and start with Team Dark, so that you guys can watch me do the game a little bit, and we can see what the story is. So,
sweet.
Here we go.
This must be it. I found Eggman's secret treasure.
Yeah, they're shed on the capsule right there. And I'll explain to you guys why he's in that capsule when we get into the gameplay.
That was like random.
Those are some huge knockers. Anyway, back to the game.
I'm gonna slap you.
Anyway, back to the game.
Why
But my question is, she's a bat, and how can she have them anyway?
I don't know.
You can't remember anything. Then it settles. Now you two make up, so we can start looking for Eggman together. Oh yeah, baby. This makes us a team. What the? Oh my god, okay. Well, that's gonna be
how many questions do you have?
Okay, it's not even questions. I'm gonna nitpick here. The voice acting is terrible.
I know. The production values were kind of low. The best, I'd say the best Sonic games that made the jump to 3D was Adventure 1 and 2. Those are like some of the best, so.
His nose moves.
Yeah, Shadow's nose.
Weird.
Okay, so here we go. Here's basically, now remember, every level that you guys see me do, you guys are going to be going through the same thing. So basically, the backstory of why Shadow was in a capsule was that at the end of Sonic Adventure 2, which was the game before this, I did that game for a series. If you guys want to, you guys can watch me do the game. It's on the channel. Basically, the idea of why Shadow was in a capsule was he fell from space. At the end of Sonic Adventure 2, he stops the Bio Lizard with Sonic, which was about to have the Space Colony arc, which was a creation, that's it. He was a creation by Eggman's grandfather, Gerald Robotnik. And then they were gonna stop it, but the reason why Shadow fell to Earth is because he couldn't control the super form. It was too powerful for him. And in Sonic Adventure 2, he was just created. He just came out of his capsule, like Eggman just woke him up. So that's basically what happened. And then he fell to the Earth, and now in Sonic Heroes they resurrected him, and now he has amnesia. That's basically what happened. He was never supposed to come back into a game, but the fans demanded it because he was too powerful. Damn it, Omega, why'd you slide off? Yeah, that's the issue that you're gonna have with Knuckles, is he slides a lot, Ryan. And then I'll tell you guys a little bit of the basics of what I'm doing as well. I mean, it's pretty fast.
So wait, does that mean that Sonic is also a creation?
No, Sonic is just a regular blue hedgehog that runs fast.
And, isn't Shadow supposed to be, like,
yeah, exactly. That's actually what they talk about in SA2. It's like, hey, you know, why Shadow? You're a clone of me. It's like, you know, I'm actually better than you, because Shadow was made to be the ultimate life form by Gerald Robotnik. That's basically what he was supposed to be.
And he wasn't.
No, he was, and he still is. He still is the ultimate life form, and he's actually a hedgehog. But the thing is, in this game, and in the next game, Shadow the Hedgehog, because he has amnesia, he keeps wondering if he's actually a hedgehog or if he's Eggman's robots. Because remember what Omega said, it must limit all Eggman's robots?
Yeah.
Yeah, because now we have the question saying, hey, you know, is Shadow a robot or is he actually a hedgehog? And of course, Rouge knows everything about his past and does nothing with it. So we have two games for Shadow's past that don't even need to be there. And Shadow the Hedgehog is the ultimate example of that. So,
well, even in the intro, what I noticed was that even though the robot was destroying the robots, he wasn't exactly aiming for Shadow.
Yeah, Eggman. Yeah, Omega took the school shooting of stormtroopers, basically.
Yeah.
And the Rainbow Rings, basically, that has you skip past a section of the level where it gives you a whole bunch of points. And by the way, did you see Shadow level up? Then just then it was like something I ran into. That's a checkpoint. So. Exactly, and then basically, if I was to fall off the map right now, I would respawn at that checkpoint.
Nice!
Yeah, exactly. So it's not like Mario where you have to start at the very beginning of the level.
Unless if you reach one of those checkpoints in Mario, which happens how many times?
Zero.
Like, once or twice, yeah, in the original Mario series.
You hate Mario because of why again?
I hate Mario because you basically lose all information whenever you can't, like, say.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
That's one of the things that makes it one of the most difficult and most difficult platforms.
Yeah.
Mario 3 have checkpoints
to Yeah, I mean, a lot of the classic games did that. Yeah, so you can hear Omega saying Annihilate a lot.
Yeah.
But yeah, basically, oh yeah, and I'll show you Team Dark's special ability right here. It's Chaos Inferno.
Chaos Control!
It stops time, and it destroys everything on the screen.
I'm out.
See, look, the timer's not going. There it goes. Now the timer's going again. Yeah, it stops time for about 10 seconds, but the only problem with that is that you'll have to wait until because it also freezes progression, so there may be times that you'll find yourself stuck until the flow of time is restored. But you can automatically cancel it. I don't know if it's for any other team, but I know for Team Dark, you can hit the R1 button again to cancel out the time freeze.
Sweet.
Yeah. And basically, a quick tip, basically anybody who passes the checkpoint gets a level up. So if there's a character that's not maxed out that you want to max out, just have them cross the checkpoint. And enemies drop level ups as well. That's why you'll see those little like random blue or red balls. Enemies drop level ups as well. I saw that rhyme. You're like looking into the camera awkwardly, like.
I was looking at the screen and I just got like.
Yeah, I
could.
And remember those dash panels, and then of course you're gonna have a lot of
the random whales.
Yeah, this is actually Seaside Hill. This is actually one of the classic areas. See, look, there's one of the orbs that the enemies drop. That would have been a level up for Shadow, but since he's level 3, I can't level up anymore. They can level up a total of 3 times, and you see how Omega has that missile barrage? That's only a level 3. Kill. Oh, Omega does that whenever there's points. He says kill a lot. He says annihilate and kill a lot. It's funny. Another thing that's really funny too is that Omega knows he's a badass robot, but all he cares about is taking out one of Eggman's creations, including Eggman himself. Yeah, it's really, really funny. And if you see that little key at the bottom of my ring counter, those unlock something called the special stages. Now, in order to get to the final boss battle with Metal Sonic, you have to get all the Chaos Emeralds in there's 7 of them. Now, with Team Dark, Team Sonic, and Team Chaotix, did you see how long the level is already? It's already about 5 minutes. If you take damage, you lose the key. That's what happens. But don't worry, it's not like there's one key in the stage and then give up if you lose the key. No, stages have multiple keys. But I didn't even touch a goddamn robot there. But the thing is that if you want to try it again, there's other keys that are located in cages. The best team to go for this for is Team Rose, because they have the shortest levels. You're going to be having stages for about 3 to 5 minutes. Ryan, you're going to be in about middle of mine, so probably maximum you'll have is about 7 to 8 minutes. My levels can be obnoxiously long. It's ridiculous. And that's the end of the stage, so.
He's got skates on his shoes, doesn't he?
Yeah, Shadow does. He has air propelled skates. Yeah.
Okay, he speaks to my soul.
Shadow does.
Yes.
Now let's see.
I roller play so much.
And yes, you do get ranked. I think that's an A rank. Yep. Perfect
is all. So is that like?
That's your highest ranking. That's the highest rank you can get in the game. Now I'm making this look extremely easy for
you
Team
are.
Dark.
Yeah, because you just like.
Because I play too much of this game. Okay. I like this game, but. When you guys are playing the levels, don't worry about getting A ranks and shit. But
okay.
Ryan, just for fair warning for you, if you do fall off the level and you lose all your score, that means not an E rank. And that's the lowest rank you can get. I'm just letting you know that. So if you get an E rank, don't worry about it. Now, special stages, the way it works is that in stage act 1, there's 2 acts. There's 2 acts per zone. So, oh yeah, and yeah, if you thought the Butterfeet physics were horrible in the game, wait until you try special stages. You see how
I'm. Oh my gosh, you're so jittery.
Yeah. Look how I'm barely moving left and right. And Omega's. Look at that. I'm barely moving it.
We won't like it.
Oh my dear gosh.
Oh, I just got stopped there. Now, basically, the Act 1 special stages. So, basically, what you want to do is that there's something called 2 acts per zone. And they're bringing it back from Classic Sonic. The way it works is that in order to get the Chaos Emerald special stages, you have to get the key on level 2. So basically, in order for me to get the Chaos Emerald for this stage, I have to get the key in the second level of the Seaside Zone. That's basically how it works. It's a little hard to explain, but you'll get it when you guys go along.
I feel like we're watching this all the
time. I know, because
like,
you're so quick.
Gosh, you feel like I'm on the track. And hurts my eyes.
I know, this is the problem.
Why are you picking up random balls?
Oh, the things? Orbs? That, you look at the top right, you see that little, that meter right there? That little meter?
Yeah.
Yeah, basically, the orbs is what keeps your speed going. I'm constantly mashing the square button to gain boost speed. See, level 2, level 3. See, you grab the star orbs and the colorful orbs to keep your speed going. But the obstacles are two things. There's spike balls that slow you down tremendously, and the worst f***ing control I've ever f***ing experienced in a Sonic game. Look at that.
Oh,
I'm slightly tilting left and right, and Shadow is going that fucking fast. It's ridiculous. But yeah, and I'm just doing this for extra lives and points. There's absolutely no point to the special stage besides getting bonuses.
I don't think I'm going to worry about special stage.
Yeah.
Then. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get all the Chaos Emeralds. You guys can attempt them if you want, but if you guys mess up, I'll go back and get them off screen.
Wait, what do you mean?
Oh, when we're not recording. So let's see how many lives
I
got.
I don't know.
Three extra lives from doing all that.
What is that?
I feel like you should earn more for that.
I know! Especially how good I was doing with the controls. especially how good I was doing with the controls as well.
Yeah. It's like freaking Butterfingers over there.
Yeah. I don't wanna know where that I don't wanna know where that thing's been.
We'll say it right now.
I'll say it right now.
That's a really nice sausage.
Oh my god. Yeah, I have my dog. Yeah, she's so
I was
fat.
Supposed to say that.
Okay, fine, you said. Ow! Now you really didn't hit me.
Abuse!
Look at me!
Abuse! Call child support!
I know.
I'm probably the burliest person here.
Okay, so now we're in stage 2 of the first act. So this is the stage where if I get the key, it'll be a castle.
Oh, wait, this is still level 1?
This is stage 2 of act 1. So this is actually level 2.
Oh.
There's two acts per zone. They brought it back from Classic Sonic.
So when is your stage finish?
This stage will finish after here. After this, I actually have a boss fight with Eggman. Yeah, no, and then right now what I'm doing is basically when you select a team, you're doing every one of their levels in the story. In order to stop their level, you have to go back to the main menu. So that's basically what happens. So if we want to, we can do this one episode of yeah, Key. Yeah. So basically, yeah. Now I'm gonna try to get the Chaos Emerald at the end of this level. I hope I can do it. Oh, I missed a checkpoint. Omega, thank you.
Shadow's voice acting is the best.
Shadow's?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and this is another thing you're gonna do too. See that fan right there? For this, you want to switch to power formation, and then you jump, and then you hold X, and then you can hover. It's basically it's called triangle dive. That's basically what it's called. Now, see how Omega's at level 1? When I do a barrage, it's machine guns. And then at level 2, it's a flamethrower, and then at level 3, it's that missile barrage you guys saw. And then when Shadow's homing attack at level 3, it one shots all enemies, even with health bars. And the other thing too is that the only issue between this game and the classic games, and this is the Sonic game where they actually introduce enemies with health bars, and that's going to become very obnoxious in later levels, and you guys will see why.
Go down.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, that was too fast. Yeah, I almost fell off the level there. Yeah, see how freaking quick that is with dash panels. I wasn't doing anything. I should have been spinning in circles.
I think you lost
half.
Yeah, I got hit. But there's another key. Oh yeah, this is another thing that I don't think Team Rose can do this, but I know Team Sonic can. Basically, what it is, it's called triangle. It's called a wall bounce. I think it's you can jump between the walls like that with the X button.
Probably, my team probably doesn't have.
Yeah, you also don't have a light speed dash. Checkpoint, I passed it. Thank you. Alright, now all the characters are level 3. Rainbow Straight, yeah, I did it. Rainbow Ring. One of them. Good. There's actually some levels in here that I legitimately do love in this game. Some of the levels. Christ, some of them are ridiculous. This is what the Rocket Excel is. You see how worthless that was?
Yeah.
I can run at that speed. Pretending such a damn robot there. Oh yeah, and if you jump up in the air as any power character, you can do something called fire dunking, which uses your enemies, your friendlies as projectiles. So look at this. So it's like that. All the power characters can do that.
How did they not get broken bones?
Oh well, the hedgehogs, they have their spin dash formation where they're in a defensive form where they can't get hurt.
That's, okay, never mind. That's Pikachu.
But yeah.
Where's the turtle going?
Where's the turtle going? Oh yeah, look at this. We're on turtles.
Turtles.
Oh, there's another ring. Team Blast. Oh, yeah, and there's something else I'm going to have to show you guys, too. It's called a Team Blast Glitch. You guys can use this if the level is becoming really a pain to you, because, I mean, a lot of LPers do the glitch, and I can see why. You see how my levels fill up a little bit?
Yeah.
What you do is that you switch to flight formation, and you press square and triangle at the same time. Now watch what happens. You see how my bar went up?
Yeah.
Basically, what happens is you're hitting the switch button and the thunder shoot button at the same time, and Rouge doesn't know what to do, so she flips the hell out, and for some reason it causes your team blast meter to fill up. It's so weird, and you can do it until it's full. Look at that. Activation's ready.
Is that only work for Team Savage?
Nope. All the teams can do it.
Oh.
Every team can do it. So if the level is becoming really, really obnoxious, like enemy set for you guys, especially like there's later enemies where they have a lot of health. So if it's becoming like really a pain to take them out, or if they're just, you know, treating you like shit, then you could just do it. Yeah, that's one nice sausage.
This is the sausage. Look at that face. Yes.
Oh, yeah, she's all up.
She's like,
London, what are you doing? Lay down, sweetie.
I don't mind. Well,
okay. But yeah, that's basically how the gist of it is. After I do the boss fight, we can move on to another team for you guys, so you guys can play for a little bit. Okay, well, okay, I had a shield, so thank God I didn't lose the key. I think I actually have one more chance of getting a key. Oh yeah, and by the way, they like to say, I'll take it from here, a whole lot more than long time no see. Oh, because every time you switch, watch, listen.
I'll take it from here.
I'll take it
from here. I'll take it from here.
I'll take it from here. Long time no see. Nope. Yeah, they all say, I don't know what it is with Team Sonic and their fetish with that line, but every Sonic game, they at least say long time no see like 4 or 5 times in each Sonic game.
I think it's like a joke. Not a joke. It has to do with the history of Sonic. Because I used to own a Sonic comic book that talked about the Sonic universe.
Oh.
Sonic.
How many games were
on
this game?
There was all the classic games, and you had Adventure 1 and 2. So you only had 2 3D games before this one. By the way, when you guys approach this section, do not go into flight formation, because you can't switch formations in midair. And the reason why I say that is because of this. You see that big boulder? It's gonna come at us. If you're in flight formation, you can't free fall really quick, and then you'll get hit. Team Sonic is gonna have to avoid this, but Team Rose doesn't. Unless you want to switch with Ryan, because Team Sonic's a little bit more challenging.
I don't know. I mean, I only got that many
roses. Well, all of the teams, they all Oh my god, Omega. All of the teams that control exactly the same. They all have the exact same handling and acceleration with everything. And there's the end of the stage. Now I can get the Chaos Emerald. Hopefully I can do it. The Chaos Emerald's a lot more intense because because once the Chaos Emerald reaches the goal ring, it's over. If you don't reach it, that's the end of the special stage. That's also an A rank.
A.
C? It's a fucking C!
Oh, because you took damage?
Well,
and
you
almost
lost the key.
I lost some ring bonus, and well, yeah, I mean, these numbers, you know, it's my Adventure 2 mentality, where I keep thinking that, you know, 70,000 points is going to be an A rank, but no, you know, in Sonic Heroes' case, Team Dark has to be close to 100,000 to get an A rank, it seems like. Okay, here we go. Now it's an Emerald Challenge. You see how that works? So level one of a new stage is bonus challenges, and then second level of the stage is an emerald challenge. So now we're gonna get a green emerald. Now I gotta focus for this. That'd be sick.
So do you go faster or can you get more?
Yeah, every time you hit those orbs, you go faster. That's the point of the special stage. You have to catch it. I'm barely even moving left and right. I'm gonna get it here. Yes! Woo! That's the end of the stage. I'm sure you guys are like, God damn, that was too quick.
Yeah. Well, we're playing here all day, so.
Yeah.
You what?
So we're playing here all day, while I am.
All day? I got 3 1 ups from there. See, now we have 6 more emeralds to get. And it doesn't matter. Every team can go for an emerald, and then it adds up to the 7 in the end. Okay. People used to think that only one team can get all 7, but any team can get any. And then it all adds up to 1. So, alright, so now we're going to see one of the boss fights that you guys are going to have with Dr. Eggman.
Yay! The caricature of Theodore Roosevelt.
The ripoff!
Yeah,
this is the Egg Hawk.
So, you're the ones who are playing games with my army.
The Egg Hawk.
Primary target detected. Destroy Dr. Eggman.
Get to kill your own president. This is the Egg Hawk. And this is actually a very easy fight, and you'll see why.
We're talking to you, Doctor.
Yeah. It kind of pretty original, isn't it? Okay. The reason why it's so easy is because you can just fire duck in the cockpit. Look at that. Look how much health I'm taking off by fire ducking him in the cockpit. Look at this.
Whoa!
Whoa! Done.
What?
Look how easy that is.
This isn't the end.
Why were you talking through your teeth? Look at that. Look how easy that was. And also, with boss battles, you're ranked on how fast you complete them. There's no team bonuses or anything. You're ranked on how fast you can complete them. That's it.
Okay.
So I'm gonna be so
27 long. Seconds. That's it. Aaron.
Cruiser battleship destroyed.
Watch it behind the speed.
I know, it's ridiculous. And that's the end of Seaside Hill. Now we're gonna go into our second stage, our second act.
Bravo!
Second
act. Bravo!
Bravo, yes sir.
So, you're the ones playing games with my army.
What was that from?
That was what Eggman just said.
Oh yeah.
See, stage 3, Grand Metropolis. I can't even
Grand
say it.
Grand Metropolis,
that's it. I haven't said that stage in a while, all right? Grammar Nazi. Oh my god.
I can do it because I'm German.
Yeah, I am too, so.
So, yeah.
Five more.
Alright. So for this, this is the second part, but we're going to stop this episode right here because it's been about 30 minutes. And we're going to record the first part of whatever team you guys want to try first.
Sweet.
So, alright. So we will see you guys in the next episode of Sonic Heroes.
Yeah.
Get a pose for Sonic Heroes.
I just believe it.